Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of the Connect series. My name is Adrian Fernandez, and today we're doing a little bit of a role switch up here where Nick Smith will be joining us here as a guest to enlighten us about our expanding and scalable Bluetooth portfolio. And for those that haven't joined in before the series, all we do is talk about connectivity technology and how TI is enabling the next wave of connected applications. So really excited to dive specifically into Bluetooth being an extremely popular, you know, connectivity standard. So Nick, thanks for hanging out. Happy to see you. It's been a while. Obviously this situation, environment's a little different, but happy to be talking to you again.
Yeah, thanks for having me, I guess. It's interesting being a guest here. We'll see once you start peppering me with questions. Yeah, good to see you. Anxious to get back in the office soon.
For sure. Well, we'll dive right in, and I do have a couple of questions for you. So we'll start off, you know, I guess specifically, we just released a brand new part to kind of commit to developers that we're going to continue to expand our portfolio. Can you maybe start there? You know, what is this new part that we're releasing, and why is it so important in terms of filling in our portfolio for developers?
Yeah, good question. So we just released a new Bluetooth Low Energy SoC. It's the CC2640R2L. So that's a device with an integrated ARM core application processor, onboard flash, and then a separate radio core. What we do is, or what we're looking at with our portfolio here, is just continuing to expand so that when, you know, a customer uses one of our BLE devices, they can match up the feature set that they need with the device from our portfolio. So our goal is to give them that scalability all the way from the more basic applications to the full-featured, more complicated applications with our portfolio. And that's part of the reason we released this CC2640R2L.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, and maybe like a little bit of a history lesson. So I know we had the 2640R2F already. You know, where does the R2L fit next to some of our existing established devices?
Yeah, good question. So I'll start with the 2640R2F that you mentioned. That was the first device we released on the SimpleLink platform. That has an ARM Cortex M3 application MCU. It has 128K of flash, 20K of RAM, and it was kind of the bread and butter, the first SimpleLink BLE device. It's really great for peripheral type applications or network attached type applications. It has full support for the Bluetooth 4.2 feature set, and it's able to be certified up to Bluetooth 5.1. And it can run limited 5.0 feature set. So it's just a good bread and butter BLE device. What we did with the R2L is scaled that device back a little bit. We took out some of the features that enable extra low power, and there's a little lower RF performance, not by much. And other than that, it's very similar. It has the M3, it's still flash-based with the 128K of flash, but we scaled it back to enable everybody to have access to a high-quality TI BLE device. This device is going to be on the web for 85 cents for everybody to get started with.
Okay, incredible. So I guess when we look at the R2L versus the R2F, we're kind of giving the developers, I guess, knobs that they can turn to kind of fine-tune the right device offering for their careabouts. And just to recap, make sure I'm capturing everything, we're really enabling them to have the right price point to feature sort of ratio. And it sounds like the features are specifically around power and maybe RF performance.
Yeah, absolutely. And maybe if I give a quick high-level breakdown, right? If you want to get into BLE with high-quality TI devices, the lowest price point is this R2L device at 85 cents. It's priced at kind of the basic entry-level BLE device price point, but it's flash-based with TI quality. A lot of other BLE devices you'll see at that price point are OTP, one-time programmable with no flash. You can't upgrade them in the field. They don't have the advanced security features we have. So that's your lowest price entry point. Then, you know, still staying with kind of the peripheral or network attached, the R2F that we talked about, that one's offered in a very small 2.7 by 2.7 millimeter chip scale package. It's your lowest power basic BLE, and then it's also your smallest size entry point. We have a couple other devices. If you move up to the CC2642R, that's our full featured BLE device. It has all of the Bluetooth 5 feature sets. It has Bluetooth 5.1 feature sets like angle of arrival and locationing features. So that's really your higher-end BLE device. It has more flash. It has 352K of flash. We've upgraded the application's core to an M4F, so you can really scale up. And then as a part of that CC2642R platform, we have options like adding an integrated PA if you need higher output power and longer range, or a very unique TI technology that integrates the crystal into the package of the device so that you have a very high accuracy resonator on board the device. So, you know, as you said, you can really scale and match your desired feature set and cost point to our portfolio.
Love it. Okay, no, I think I've got the lay of the land now. So you kind of have the CC2640R2F as kind of your bread and butter, kind of middle of the road, but high performance with low power capabilities. You can scale down if cost is a big care about for you, and that's where the R2L comes into play. Or if you need extra premium features like, I guess, DMM, more memory, that's where the 2642R2 comes into play.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually, that you brought up that I didn't mention about that 2642R family. There's a device in that family called the 2652R, which you alluded to, that can run multi-protocol. So it can run both BLE and Zigbee, for instance, with a single radio.
Very cool. Okay, awesome. And when we talk about scalability up and down a portfolio, I know package options is also a key care about. You know, are these devices pin compatible?
Yeah, very good question. So the R2F and R2L have a variety of different package types and sizes to meet your application need. But what's common about all of the devices we've talked about is a 7x7 QFN package. And if you get any of the devices in this package, they're completely pin-to-pin compatible. So with a single hardware design, you can scale your portfolio from the R2L all the way up to the multi-protocol 2652R.
Very cool. And I assume the scalability applies to software as well.
That's right. Yeah, we actually have, I think, one of our very first videos where we talk about the benefits of the SimpleLink platform and the software scalability. But the short story is, yeah, it's a common SDK across all of these devices, so you can really re-leverage your software across any of them.
Very cool. Nick, that's incredible. So really excited to provide developers, customers with that scalable portfolio. It's kind of a one-stop shop. You know, as your requirements change, you can move up and down our portfolio seamlessly, both from a hardware and software perspective. So with that in mind, you know, where do developers go to get more information and learn more about this portfolio?
Yeah, good question. As always, ti.com/SimpleLink is a great resource. If you go straight to ti.com/BLE, you can start to explore these different devices and part numbers that we've spoken about today. Again, really give a look to the R2L. That's 85 cents for a very high quality BLE wireless SoC. Then check out the CC2652RB. That's a completely unique device on the market that enables you to do a completely crystalless wireless design. So that's a huge benefit from the system cost and space saving side as well. ti.com/BLE.
Perfect. Well, Nick, thank you so much. We should do this more often. Who knew? You were a wealth of knowledge, at least when it pertains to Bluetooth. So super excited to learn more about our portfolio and, you know, how we're bringing to market new products to fill in that portfolio offering for developers. So thanks for hanging out. And for those watching at home or in the office, wherever you might be, thanks for tuning in. As always, tune in next week for more SimpleLink Experts, where we dive into more technology and ways TI is enabling, you know, connected applications. And as always, feel free to give us any feedback or questions or comments on Twitter at @SensorToCloud. We're always happy to hear your thoughts and comments there. So thank you so much, and we'll talk to you next time.